Watch what's approaching. The supreme moment. Reality striking closer than it seems, don't it? Go ahead, it's for the taking if you want it. If not, the dream dies and you'll be forever haunted. Then confront it.
Happy belated Valentine's Day. I meant to do this yesterday, but with my work schedule and all the events planned out, I didn't have time to do it. So again, this was a pretty much Valentine's Day themed showcase. Hopefully you guys had a good one, whatever it is that you were doing at the time. But this one is going to be a little bit of a tribute to Social Fire, because for those that know, Android 21 is pretty much like a mascot for her. So with that being said, happy Valentine's Day, and let's go ahead and get with the showcase. As always, if you enjoy the content, definitely make sure to like the video. And if you're new to the channel, definitely hit the subscribe button. So again, this is the Extreme Strength Android 21 unit. It is a transformation unit. I actually picked up all the copies I needed to rainbow her a while back, but finally decided to do that fairly recently. And I was actually like, you know what, instead of doing a showcase now, let's just go ahead and wait till Valentine's Day. It would be an appropriate unit to showcase. So here we are. Again, the leader skill for this unit, Android's category key +3, HP attack defense increase of 150%. Super attack will cause immense damage to enemy and recovers 10% HP. Key +3, attack and defense increase of 90%. Attacked enemies, attack and defense minus 20% for 2 turns. And also transforms when conditions are met. That's the passive skill. Now for the transformation condition, it's a 30% chance to consume cell when HP is 50% or above, starting for the 4th turn from the start of battle. Looks like for the Lynx, it's Android Assault, that's defense increase of 1000, Metamorphosis is 5% HP recovery, Battlefield Diva is +2 key, Brainiac's attack and defense increase of 10%, Fear and Faith is key +2, Big Bad Bosses is 25% to attack and defense when HP is 80% below, or and then Fierce Battle is attack increase of 15%. The unit falls into 4 categories: Peppy Bell, I can't even talk straight right now. Peppy Gals, Androids, Full Power, and Transformation Boost. At 100% potential, you've got the following stats: so 13,162 for HP, attack is 14,496, and defense is 8,421. 12 key multipliers, 145%. Let's move on and talk about the transformed state. So a couple of changes, especially with the super attack and passive skill. So with the transformation, the super attack will cause immense damage to enemy and lowers attack and defense. Passive skill is a key +3, attack and defense increase of 130% and recovers 13% HP at the start of turn. Disables enemy guard when performing a super attack. So you know, this unit's fairly old. We can say it's fairly old. I mean, it came out on JP on July 31st of 2018, so it's been a little while. But with that being said, this unit's actually performing pretty well. I mean, I tested this not even a week ago, so it's obviously on a up-to-date, type team with a lot of units that have either gotten easy A's or they're relatively new units. So with that being said, the unit's actually doing pretty well, and I think really helped is obviously the passive boost toward attack. You start off with 90% with the pre-transformation, after the transformation you get 130% boost to both attack and defense, certainly helpful there. I think the super attack ability recovers HP, right? And then the passive skill after transforming will recover HP as well. I can't remember exactly what I went with. I either went with 1511 or 917. I know I showed it at the very beginning, but I couldn't tell if I actually prioritized the HP recovery built in from the super attack, or I just went with the 917 distribution, which is typically what I would do if they don't have the Kaioken mechanic where attack and defense can be stacked up on the super attack. I typically like to go with a 917 distribution. I mean, obviously it depends on the unit skill sets themselves, but I almost feel like for this one I went with 917 instead of 1511. But either way, you can't really go wrong with whichever option you do. It's just honestly a different preference, to be perfectly transparent with you. So with that being said, either way is fine. Point being, this unit's still pretty good. Again, like I said, July of 2018, so it's close to 2 years that it's been out. I mean, we're getting to, it's February right now, so it's a couple of months down the road, we'll make it the 2-year mark. So, I mean, I guess it's new enough, but at the same time, you know, close to 2 years can be a lifetime on Dokkan Battle, especially with all the brand new units that continue to come out. So, fairly good performer, and I think, you know, definitely has a spot in a variety of teams still, you know, especially like Peppy Gals, of course. Androids, you know, that's a befitting category team for that. Transformation Boost is pretty much what is being tested on here, so that's, you know, preferably what I would typically run on this setup, especially with the Transforming Cooler as leaders. Very phenomenal unit, and you have you can actually combine two categories, so Conquest of Terror and Transformation Boost. It's probably one of the best combinations of categories in my opinion right now, and I personally love it. I absolutely love this leader skill and the unit itself and all the teams you can build around it. So, you know, overall, you know, I've always been a fan of movie bosses. Like, the movie boss category was my personal favorite prior to Transforming Cooler coming out. And it's kind of like a hybrid offshoot of that, because a lot of units that were on movie bosses falls into either the Conquest of Terror or the Transformation Boost categories. So it all works out for me, because I honestly really love the movie boss category anyhow. But back to the Android 21 unit. You know, I remember when it first came out. We obviously have the free-to-play version as well. It's a pretty decent support unit for the Android category. But since then, you know, there's some various free-to-play units that have come out that are pretty good Android support as well. So, you know, the free-to-play version of Android 21, not necessarily as viable nowadays as this one, but yeah, this chick can definitely do some damage still. And I think the HP recoveries, you know, reducing the enemy stats will certainly help as well. You know, like attacked enemy, attack and defense minus 20% for 2 turns, that could actually save you a lot of potential damage and shorten the battle a little bit, especially in settings like Super Battle Road and stuff like that. So, you know, a lot to be said with that. I think, I think there's plenty of room for this girl still. And it's funny, because I think this just came out on Legends as well. So, you know, Android 21 at the end of the day is still a very popular character in the Dragon Ball universe. So, you know, certainly, it's funny, because we only have like one summonable version of this. I don't know if they plan on bringing out more versions of it through, you know, upcoming banners. I'm sure they will at some point, but this unit is certainly still very, very good, and it'll be a little while till we get a new version, I think. At the very least, I would like to see an EZA in at least a year and a half, maybe 2 years at some point. It's hard to predict how Dokkan Battle is going to look in 2 years, because so much has changed even the course of the last 2 years. If you think about it, there has been a lot of changes that have occurred in the past 2 years, and, you know, it's hard to predict what the future looks like. You know, 2 years ago, around this time, is when we literally got, the transforming units introduced, right? It was like the LR Gogeta and LR Vegito came out, and it was definitely a game changer, and a lot of things have been introduced since then, so it's a wild environment to be in, and constantly changing, so we'll see what kind of units come out in the future, but you know, of course, at the end of the day, my love for the older units are always going to be existing, and I certainly do get enjoyment out of rainbowing older units and bringing them back into the limelight. I actually have another showcase scheduled for tomorrow that you guys haven't seen, so it'll definitely be a fun one to do. I've actually been wanting to do this for a while, and it's finally available on GP, so stay tuned for that one. I already have the recordings, I just have to do the commentary and publish it on YouTube, and you guys will see it. But it'll definitely be up tomorrow at some point, so definitely stay tuned for that. But again, this was the showcase for the 100% Extreme Strength Android 21 unit on the Conquest of Terror and Transformation Boost categories. Hopefully you enjoyed it. As always, thanks for watching, and I will catch you guys later.